Welcome back to Earth Changes Radio, Season 2, Episode 1, The Ancient Observatory Report. In today's show, the two hosts talk about the changes under the Earth, on the Earth, and above the Earth. And now, the two hosts that give Hillary to Clinton an instant enema, it's Rick and Steve on the Terraforming Earth Network. Take it away, boys!
Yeah, thank you very much, Carol. Lock her up, lock her up, lock her up, that damn little witch. Welcome to another edition, Season 2 of Earth Changes Radio, earthchangesradio.com. Hello to everybody. Glad to be here tonight. If you hear some noise, fireworks, gunshots, screaming, random noise during the show, hey, it's just my neighbor having a typical New Mexico barbecue. And that is a fact. Hello to everybody in the chat room and who's joining us, Mr. K, Lady B, and everyone. We're missing one of our admins tonight. Ruby today cannot be with us. Unfortunately, her father just recently passed, and our condolences to Ruby today and all of her family and our friends. Hello to all of our sponsors. We have sponsors. Hey, how about that? Season 2, show number 1, howtowinincourt.com. Howtowinincourt.com. Mishkaites. See their products at the bottom of our webpage, www.earthchanges.com. Mishkaites. We have the High Desert Gaming Society will be joining us. We have the Southwest Backpackers, and of course, a big thank you to Big Whoop Magazine. James Blackburn Experience and Authentic Western Shootouts in Old Town, New Mexico, Albuquerque, New Mexico, through the end of August. You guys don't want to miss that, and if you're traveling through Albuquerque, you might want to check that out, but please don't call me. We have a lot of interesting things tonight, Steve. We've had 2 weeks off. It's good to see you. How you doing tonight, bud?
Well, it's certainly fantastic to be here, Mr. Earthplay, and then there has been a lot of things happen over the last 3 weeks or 2 weeks that we've been off, and indeed it's been a great break. But it's time to get back to business. It's time to start reporting on the changes under the Earth, on the Earth, and above the Earth. And indeed, there is so much happening. We've seen some amazing images from the Cassini mission that has gone past Saturn, and indeed is on its last flyby into Jupiter. We've seen some amazing video of some of the auroras that are happening on Saturn. If you haven't seen that, by all means, do a search for that and check it out. Some fantastic, amazing images coming out from the far reaches of our galaxy. And there's a lot of things, apparently, that they're finding at the edge of our solar system that they've never seen before that we're now seeing here on Earth. The amazing images that we are seeing and the amazing objects that they're finding out that are floating around outside the sphere of our solar system. But that's not to worry us, because indeed, we here on Earth, we've got enough problems here on Earth, more so than to worry about what's happening out there in the cosmos. But it's great to see everybody here, and indeed, I'd like to put out a shout to our sponsors, who are indeed the Southwest Backpacker, Organite by Mishkaites, which you can check out on Facebook, and howtowinincourt.com. Some great sponsors there for the show today, and this is Season 2, Episode 1, or Episode 21, if you're keeping count. And we've got a lot of stories coming up in the show today, but first of all, I'd like to say thank you to all the listeners and all the people in the chat room today. It's great to see everybody. Byria, Mr. Kinnikate, Miss Lady B, Energy Supply, good to see Dire Warning, one of our solid admins, Love is Light, good to see you, ma'am. Mr. MW, God bless. And of course, the famous, the infamous, the out there guy, Mr. Earthplay himself. Are you there, Mr. Earthplay? Earth calling Major Tom. Are you there, Mr. Rick, sir?
5x5. We are definitely here tonight. And yes, we're learning a lot of interesting things going on in space with us. But firstly, we have to tell you that this show comes with a disclaimer. If you're suffering from mental illness and or depression, be advised that tonight's show will disturb you. So if you're on medications or under a doctor's supervision, you may want to check with him if our show content is going to set you off or trigger you or not. Look, Steve, I just recently found out where we are in the Milky Way from the Lawrence Laboratory, National Laboratory. It's the LNL.gov site, Lawrence Livermore National Laboratory, where they're making a composite map of the Milky Way galaxy and our position to it. And I have found out that our position to the Milky Way galaxy is that we are just now rising above the northern ecliptic of the Milky Way galaxy. And we're going to have a lot more news on this coming up in the show. But to remind everybody, it's August 1st, Tuesday, August the 1st, and we do have a solar eclipse, a full solar eclipse, up August the 21st. And indeed, a lot of stuff going on out there at the fringe of our solar system, at the edge of the heliosphere, where there seems to be a magnetic sea of bubbles. This is being reported by Voyager 1 and Voyager 2. Inexplicably, we're still getting information from these little critters way out there. So we're going to talk about that a little bit tonight, in tonight's show as well, Steve. So heads up, if you don't have that marked on your calendar, and you should always keep a calendar in front of you when you're on the computer, PalTalk, especially at PalTalk.com, exclusively in our chat room, we put up a lot of dates, and we put up a lot of events, and we sure will be doing that. And join us on Facebook, because we're going to start publishing a lot of this stuff. Steve, I can't wait to get into it. We got some really hairy stuff tonight.
Well, Mr. Earthplay, I'm so glad to hear you talk about the Voyager probes. They were, in fact, launched in the mid-70s, instigated by the now very famous Dr. Carl Sagan. God rest his soul. What a legend that guy is. And these Voyager probes have been floating out into the midst of our solar system, and now they are far beyond the reach of the solar system sphere, that they are heading out into deep space, and that's good to know. I heard a recent report that nanosatellites, some of these microsatellites, are actually being deployed to go out to some of the far reaches of space that can actually make it there a lot faster and a lot more efficiently than any of our probes could ever do. So they're now planning to send these nanosatellites out into the far reaches of space to actually meet some of these floating objects and some of these ancient stars that are far, far away from Earth, which should be fascinating. I can't wait for that. But indeed, if the Voyager probes are still pumping out their signals and pumping out their information, that is fantastic. They were not designed to last that long, and to know that they're still out there, still sending signals back, it is fascinating. I can't wait to hear some information about that. One of the first stories I have for you today is, believe it or not, we hear a lot of stories on the news about Islam and about militants and about radical Muslim militants that are out there doing these bombings, doing these terrorist attacks. But guess what? Most of these Islamic militants have no idea about Islam. That's right. These supposed radical Muslims that shout Allah Akbar, they don't even know what Islam's about. I have the information here that indeed, that these guys, even though they say that they're Muslims, even though they say they're Muslims and they're being called militant Islamic terrorists, most of them have no knowledge of Islam at all. So what are they? Are they actually put up? Are they actually set up? Are they actually designed to put out a bad message for Islam? I don't know. But indeed, a lot of the evidence says that most of these attacks do come from the state itself. A lot of them are what we call useful idiots. That's the best way I can describe them. Useful idiots for an agenda for the government to come out there and do this sort of stuff and to blame a whole bunch of people based on the actions of one or two crazy assholes. That's all I can say. I'm not going to go right into that, but indeed, there's a lot of useful idiots everywhere. Just look at Congress. Just look at the Senate. You can count them, and indeed, there's a lot of them sitting down and earning a lot of money for doing bugger all. Well, Mr. Earthplay, I would like you to come in to this conversation and indeed save me. Please save me.
I don't know if you can be, Steve, because I don't really follow these things. These are things that you're hearing about on the radio and television that are completely fraudulent in their reporting, the fake media. So I don't listen to them at all. I don't have an opinion. I certainly do not have an opinion other than I remember watching some film footage of refugees, war refugees and migrants from Syria that were coming into us, Steve, and as they were coming down the ramp of the airplane, they were all young males, almost all males, a couple of women, and I think I only saw one child. And there was only about 60 people. It wasn't, you know, a whole bus. A whole bunch fit on one bus. And then I remember the perpetrator-in-chief, Barack Obama, Barry Satoru, Mr. Ears, excoriate the American public by saying, y'all are a bunch of ignorant people. Our president of the United States said that to fear women, what did he say? Women and children, to fear, I don't remember it precisely. You can go back to YouTube. It was so insulting. Like the time that he called us all ignorant because we cling to our Bibles and our guns with antipathy for anyone who is different than us, which is completely untrue. Time and time we're being insulted. I don't believe a lot of these stories. The terrorism that I have been experiencing here in rural America, in the United States of America, is from the United States federal government, from constitution-free zones and the constant war-sabery, war-rattling of nuclear war. I haven't heard about this stuff since the beginning of the 1960s during the Cuban Missile Crisis and to teach us to duck at school. So I'll tell you, I just, Steve, try not to even pay attention to these people. Until something urgent is presented to me, I don't even pay attention to this stuff, to be honest with you.
Well, you know, sir, there was an episode just recently of the John Oliver show, who does the late-night TV show in America. He made fun of Alex Jones, and whilst that was funny, whilst that was pretty hilarious, how he took the piss out of some of the products that Alex Jones has to offer, we here in the Ancient Observatory on the Earth Changes radio show, we actually have some really good products that we do promote. And we do like to show people that we do have some things to actually help you in life, including Organite by Mishkaites, which you can check out on Facebook. These crystals are healing energy power that give you the ability to recharge your body. HowToWinInCourt.com. This website will actually help you if you have some legal issues, and it doesn't cost a cent. It is online and is free for anybody to use as a resource to find out some legal information. We also have the Southwest Backpacker that helps us to realize that you have the ability to live off the grid if you so wish to. Now, the thing why I talk about John Oliver, and I don't usually talk about him in our show, because he actually took the piss out of Alex Jones, and even though he did, and it was really, really funny, he also took the piss out of the contaminants in our water supply this week on his show. Now, there is a lot of contaminants in the American people's water supply. We do know that places like Michigan have a huge problem with lead in their water. That has been reported. And we do know some of the chemicals they put in the water are indeed very, very toxic. Well, now you can actually check your water supply in America by your postcode and check whether or not you have some good water or bad water. You can check your tap water quality by going to that website that I have just there, ewg.org /tapwater/index.php. So if you think you're having problems, well, you can now check and make sure how your water is by that online resource. This is really, really important because a lot of the water that we're drinking is not good for you. especially with the fluoride that's in the water, especially with the garbage that they're pumping into it. Well, now you can check it online and check if your area, if your postcode has good water or not. They've done nationwide testing, and it's good to know. It's good to know. So to see if you're being poisoned by your local municipal water supply. Hopefully people will take that, and hopefully people will check that out. I'm going to post the link again so you can check it. And by all means, consider yourself that you have to look after your health, because nobody else is going to. The government is not going to check on your health. The government doesn't care about your health. According to them, if you get sick, that's good for business. If you get sick and go into hospital, that's good for the pharmaceuticals, because they can pump you full of drugs, and you need more drugs to cover the side effects of those drugs, and more drugs to cover the side effects of those drugs. And it's a continuing spiral of money that they make. It is a money-making enterprise, people getting sick, and I'm sick of it. I really am. People going to hospital, you only go to hospital to die. So try your best to stay out of hospital. That's my message for today. Go ahead, Earthplay.
Oh, that's a pretty good message there, Steve, and I would take it a step further. And as you well know, we talk about these topics quite frequently in the Ancient Observatory, and I would say that it's most municipalities across all of North America. And not only is it lead and mercury and other toxic substances, and heavy metal, you also have pharmaceuticals that are just off the map. And since we're going to be plugging other websites, jmcc.com, JMCC Science, I believe. James McCanny, if you don't know, he sells water filters and systems like this, and you can purify your water. I use the Sawyer, exclusively a Sawyer. Because most of the service in your home is 1/4-inch copper tubing. And it's so easy to put a Sawyer filter in there. Just turn a little faucet off, cut it, stick your Sawyer filter in there, and of course you're going to have to clamp it down. Good for 100,000 gallons. I carry them in my backpack, I carry them in my truck, I carry them in my toolbox. I carry the Sawyer Life Straw, and they're going to be so important, so important. Even drinking out of your taps, believe it or not, it has come to that. Checking in with Professor James McCanny, actually I did this week, he brought something to my attention that is very startling, and that is the oxygen content on the planet Earth. As we all know, that the Earth's environment, environment in which we breathe, maintains life on the planet, is 78% nitrogen. That's a lot of nitrogen. And 21% oxygen. 21% oxygen. It used to be very, very much higher in the past. And 1%, 0.01% carbon dioxide. This is the greenhouse gas everybody's afraid of. 0.01 buildup of carbon dioxide in the Earth's environment. Something doesn't seem right here. And then, of course, we have 0.01 of rare gases and other elements, which are probably most attributed to the nuclear industry and chemical industry. The reason I'm bringing this up is because I have heard many times, I've heard Dane Wigington say this. I've heard Professor Paul Beckwith say this. Now I'm hearing from Professor James McCanny saying this. It would appear as though the oxygen level on the Earth is shrinking, going down. It was supposed to be at 21% oxygen level in the environment. Now it's down to 20.1. That's 0.09 drop. That's almost 1/10 of a whole point drop in our oxygen level. And they're talking about the loss of zooplankton, phytoplankton, and other plankton-like life forms that most of our largest creatures, whales and other creatures, are feeding on at the bottom of the Arctic Circle and the Antarctic Circle. And this is going away probably because of ultraviolet, the intensity of ultraviolets in the ocean, and cosmic background radiation. And in the show, more on this, where they think this is coming from. But it's not something that we're going to have to tend with. It's something that we should be dealing with right now. It is a current event. It is saturating the environment. And I don't know about you, Steve, but air is one of my favorite things. For this to be a problem, this goes well beyond global warming and human-caused global warming. So pick it away, Steve.
Yeah, well, Mr. Earthplay, please don't tell the government. Please don't talk too loud when you say that you like to breathe, because the government will find a way to tax that. They'll find a way to tax you as an air consumer. If they possibly could, they would fit some kind of device to your nose to check how much air you're breathing, to tax you on the amount of oxygen that you're taking in, because you're an oxygen consumer. If they could find a way to put a meter on your face, they would do that. That's the kind of government that we have. But indeed, we actually have been waiting for Donald Trump to drain the swamp, meter face. We've been waiting for him to do good on his promises to actually start draining the swamp and start draining Washington of all the scumbags and all the leeches and all the parasites that are sucking the lifeblood out of America. But believe it or not, it has actually started. It's taken a while. It's taken over 6 months for him to actually do anything since his inauguration in January. But now, some of the first signs that he is making changes to America have been starting to dribble out. This link here, I would like to share with you, shows that there is a new legislation that has been passed to allow people, consumers, to be able to do a class action lawsuit against their banks. If your bank has been ripping you off or doing dodgy deals, you can actually get together with your fellow banking people or your fellow customers of that bank and actually now do a class action lawsuit against the banks. Everything about Russia has been proven to be bullshit. All this Trump with Russia talks and all this spy stuff, that's garbage. Even CNN, as we reported on this show, CNN have been caught red-handed, busted, lying about the Trump and Russia connection. That's complete garbage. But now, he is actually starting to drain the swamp, and I'm feeling a little bit positive about a president. And that's the first time ever, trying to think about it. I've never, ever felt positive about any president, because they're all morons. But Donald Trump does seem to be doing something to clean up Washington and to stop the illegal immigration and to stop the jobs from going off the offshore and to start getting Americans into jobs. But that's the first time I've ever heard or seen anything like that ever, because Obama has made it possible so people cannot sue the banks. George W. Bush made it possible that people cannot sue their banks. And I've even heard whispers, I believe there's rumors on the internet. You know, I'm working hard to put food on your family. I've heard rumors on the internet that he is actually starting to look into auditing the Federal Reserve. Now, that's very, very dangerous for Donald Trump to go down that path. The last time any president ever wanted to audit the Federal Reserve was JFK. And we know how that ended up, don't we? I believe there's a saying in Texas or Tennessee or wherever it is or wherever I come from. You can fool me once, shame on you. You fool me, can't get fooled again. Go on, Earth Play, try and fool me, brother. Mike is yours.
Okay, thank you, Steve. Actually, I think that Trump is doing a wonderful job. A wonderful job. I think that he still needs to go after Hillary, though. Lock her up, lock her up. Because every time I turn on the radio or through the Wife's Entertainment Center and the news or something is on, all I can do is laugh. Because the Democratic Party, and it seems like local school teachers and the local news, are also just in a tizzy over Donald Trump. The failing White House, and he's firing people and oh my God, everything is horrible. I just laugh. Reminds me of this old carpenter guy that used to wander through the desert, and he would overturn the tables in the marketplace and curse the money changers. I kind of see him that light. Not as high in stature and elevation, but I'm glad to see it happening. I don't really, Steve, I don't pay a lot of attention to the media because they're lying. Mostly, you have to read between the lines, and you have to really stay up on this stuff to even understand what's going on. And kudos to you. You're a good reporter. You're checking a lot of sites, but I don't even listen to it. In my truck, I don't listen to it. I listen to science lectures. At home, I don't listen to the news. I don't watch the news. I can't stand the news, to tell you the truth. So I'm listening to scientists, and I'm listening to lectures. And most of them right now are scratching their heads and saying, well, living with a variable star is kind of an iffy proposition. This coming from our solar physicists. So we have a lot of scientists actually sounding the alarm about, you know, global things. And the last thing I want to think about is Putin having some control over our president, rigging our elections. I mean, come on, what is this crap, Steve? You know, I'm tired of hearing about it. I don't want to hear about it, and I won't even listen to them anymore. Lying, fake media. I'm tired about hearing about nuclear war. I hope the Democratic Party just shuts the up. You can use your own expletive in there. Lock her up, lock her up. This party is completely out of control. You have one of the parties of the United States government talking about nuclear war. We have a problem, Steve. I don't know how else to relay my message to the American people that it's all a fantasy. It's all a farce. It's all a stage show just to keep you in complete turmoil so you don't understand or realize what they're trying to pull in the back room. So, constitutional zones in America, I've had it with this crap. These people if we're going to build a wall, I used to say, if we're going to build a wall, we don't need to build a wall across Mexico. We need to build a wall across Canada. Well, I've changed my mind yet again, Steve. If we're going to build a wall, let's build it around Washington, D.C. and liberate the United States of America.
Well, there's been a lot of calls to lock her up, lock her up. And the first step to locking up Hillary Clinton has been made just last week. If you've been living in a cave for the last week or so, you probably haven't heard the news, but Debbie Wasserman Schultz's IT aide, Imran Awan, excuse me, has been arrested. He was arrested trying to flee the United States after FBI agents and DC police found his home with a whole bunch of Congress people's iPhones with their Blackberries, with a whole bunch of hard drives that he tried to smash the evidence of the hacking and, of course, the spying on congressmen, of senators. And now the first of many arrests has been made, and they are looking at making some more arrests. This is the first domino to fall down in the Hillary Clinton crime syndicate. That's all it is. It is a crime syndicate with a whole bunch of criminals that are now freaking out. Debbie Wasserman Schultz, one of them, a rabid Israeli Zionist, dual citizen, dual treasonist that has Israel's benefit at her heart. She does not have America in her heart. And I'm glad to hear about that. I'm glad to see news like this that he is starting to drain the swamp. You're listening to Earth Changes Radio, and we'll be right back after this short message break.
Tahi rua toru fa. Kia ora, kia ora, kia te pihia koe. This is Deborah Chandler from Palmerston North Aotearoa on the North Island, which was Maui's fish. And you are listening to Earth Changes Radio with Rick, not Dick, and Steve on Terraforming Earth Network live on peltalk.com. Imnohora!
Hi, this is Graviton Cleric, and you are listening to Earth Changes Radio with Rick and Steve on the Terraforming Earth Network.
This is Patrick Devlin. You are listening to Earth Changes Radio with Rick and Steve on the Terraforming Earth Network, live on powertalk.com. Tashi Delek. Thank you very much.
Hi, my name is Earth Angel, and you're listening to Earth Changes Radio with Rick and Steve on paltalk.com.
Hi, my name is Scott, also known as Great Message. You're listening to Earth Changes Radio with Rick and Steve on paltalk.com. Cow, it's been so long since I used this thing, I forgot how to turn the mic on.
Hi, my name is Chuck Norris, and we're kicking ass to Earth Changes Radio at paltalk.com.
Hello, my name is Michael Kane, and you are listening to Earth Change Radio on PowerTalk.com.
You are listening to radio. What's it called again?
Earth Changes Radio.com.
Hello, my name is Cheryl, and you're listening to Earth Changes Radio on PowerTalk.com.
My name is Mindy's mum, and I mop floors when I listen to Earth Changes Radio on paltalk.com.
With over 150 million registered users, Paltalk is the largest online chat community in the world. With over 300 Paltalk support staff speaking dozens of languages to help you enjoy your online experience. Meet new people across town, country, or continent while chatting about your interests. Sing live karaoke, listen to music, join a lively political debate, or play group trivia in one of thousands of chat rooms in various categories from your PC, your tablet, or mobile device. Joining Paltalk is free and easy. Go to paltalk.com and become part of our friendly community today.
Hi, I'm Michelle, and you're listening to... Oh, I forgot what it was, because it's smooth.
Hi, I'm Ruby, and you're listening to Earth Changes Radio on paltalk.com with Rick and Steve.
My name is MW, and I have found peace from horseshit.
Well, of course, there's one of our favorite listeners and our regulars, Mr. MW, telling us that he has found peace through horseshit. And it takes all kinds of things to find peace in this world. Indeed, you cannot find it in the media. You cannot find peace in any of the news stories. You cannot find peace in your daily life unless you meditate, unless you go out and live in the wilderness for a while and indeed find yourself a nice piece of ground to just consider the world for a moment and stop and think about how the world works and what indeed it takes to find some peace in this world, because it takes all kinds of things to find peace. But my gosh, one thing I do find peace from is indeed coming here into Earth Changes Radio, where I'm able to spout and I'm able to vent. I'm able to get this stuff out and not keep it inside. Because keeping it inside, it just builds up a lot of negative energy. And that's one thing I do not want to be, is a negative Nelly. I don't want to have that inside me. I want to get it out. What do you reckon, Earthplay? This radio show is all about venting. It's all about getting this information out. It's all about spilling it, so we don't build it up and we don't have this on our conscience anymore. We're able to talk about how much we are pissed off. The world is going down in a big way. It's going down in flames, and we have the ability to change it here, now, right now. The first change to making a change is the first step. And it always takes a first step. Every journey takes the first step, and it's good to have that first step towards a better place. And the better place is here on EarthChangesRadio.com. Go ahead there, Earthplay. Your mic, sir.
Indeed. And I want to welcome Ruby today into the chat. Welcome, everybody. Odd, Tricky Dog, Ricky Dog is here. Suicide Blonde is here today. Is here today. We have Dire, Energy, Lady B, Mr. K. So if you're wondering who these people are, they're the chat participants. John is here. Other people, you pick a Nick. So some of them, Bridges. No Bridges or something. Welcome everybody to Pal Talk, paltalk.com. Every Tuesday night, and you can interact with these guys. Some of them are our sponsors, and they run their own small businesses or services like, which one do we have? howtowinincourt.com. A lot of time, these people are not accessible, but in our chat room, we know the sponsor, we know this guy that runs this website, and we can hook you up and you can talk to him. So come join us every Tuesday night. You can talk to our sponsors. My next story here, Steve, I'm going to take a step into the abyss where you're going to have to follow very closely, because this is some pretty esoteric stuff. Apparently, now, this has archaeologists and geologists and paleontologists confused beyond imagination. Apparently, there's this little place in southern Turkey that's called Göbekli Tepe. And there seems to be a little bit of a problem here. Archaeological discoveries that can't be explained, showing our position in the Milky Way galaxy. Now, this is inexplicable. How can this even be possible? But it's telling a bigger story, that about 10,900 years and 50 years BC, the stone carvings show explicitly of a comet and cometary fragments that were hitting the Earth. And it was inducing and starting a little ice age. Not only that, this was about the time they were leaving the same position that we are now. They were leaving from the northern hemisphere of the Milky Way galaxy across the Great Dark Rift, which we've talked about before, the galactic center, the galactic crossing. The same thing that I started the show off with tonight, talking about the Lawrence Livermore National Laboratory .gov, LLNL.gov, who is mapping the Milky Way galaxy. Now, how they knew this, where their position was, and all of these other phenomena that they recorded in this little, they're calling it a temple, Steve, but they left these messages for the future and then deliberately buried the town or the structure, the temples, the statues. But they show our position in the Milky Way galaxy, showing that we're approaching this same exact place. Well, we would be a few degrees off, but the same region of space that they tried to leave a warning. This is not an astronomical calendar. Is specifically a warning. That's what the entire complex, the temple, was designed to do, was to depict a position in space, and we seem to be only about 1 trillion miles from entering this exact region that they're depicting in the crossing of the galactic plane on the northern ecliptic. It's an amazing story, Steve. The more you find out, the more it's like taking you into some kind of a never land. You cannot even fathom these things. Apparently, now we are going to move into a thicker region of gas and particulates and ultraviolets, and that's what they're warning us. Not so much to record the comet impact of 10,950 years ago, which had already occurred when they started building this temple. But the main point of this temple was to warn us from excessive ultraviolet and X-rays and gammas striking the Earth and setting it ablaze. So are these things possible? Well, absolutely. Will it happen to us again? Well, inexplicably, and this is the rabbit hole, and this is I spend all day reading and talking to professors and going over the material for the grand solar minimum that science, now all science, universally tell us that we have moved into this phase of solar activity. Incidentally, last week we had an X-class flare on the other side of the Earth. Had it been facing the Earth, we would probably be facing great damage of our satellite grid, maybe our power grid closer to the ground. It's hard to say when you're dealing with a variable star. But this region that had such a large outburst that it could be seen on the Earth side of the Sun is going to now be turning into the Earth's region in the next couple. Actually, it has already started turning back to the Earth-facing side. So they're watching this very, very closely right now and think that it has something to do with where we are moving across the galactic plane into the northern ecliptic of the Milky Way galaxy. This rabbit hole gets just even deeper. I don't know if we should be calling it a rabbit hole. Let's call it an investigation. Because this investigation ties directly, Steve, to a topic we talked 2010, 2011, 2012, was the winter solstice and the Mayan calendar, while retuning it from a 360-day to a 365-degree calendar. It turns out that the Mayan weren't wrong at all. Everybody was disappointed and but it turns out that they were talking about a direct energy ramp up that hits the Earth, changes it. It would either, this time they say that it would not be by fire but by ice, now I believe that, but we move into these different ages of destruction. And this one here is going to be by water. I believe that we already had one of water, so there could be more compression within the Earth, and there is certainly, Steve, a lot more activity going on in the Earth. I wish we had the time to talk about all the earthquakes, California, Nevada, Oregon, Washington, British Canada, along the Cascadia, on the Juan de Fuca. Just saw an earthquake recently here, Steve, on the Mid-Atlantic Ridge off the, between South America and Central America, not even on the Mid-Atlantic Ridge. And the earthquakes continue throughout Mammoth Lakes and into Nevada, into the Hawthorne area. We had two earthquakes in Yosemite today, 3.3, not Yosemite, but Yellowstone, National Caldera, 3.3 and 0.7. And earthquakes continue all along the west coast, out into the Gulf of Alaska, all the way down into the volcanic activity that still continues. This is turning out to be a nightmare, Steve, with these volcanic eruptions, especially this Mount Bogolop that just will not shut off the spigot. And we've talked about this one incessantly, the acid and the deep chemical compositions that are being brought up from deep in the Earth. This is not an ordinary volcano. So I urge everybody to go to Volcano Discovery. Let me see if I got that right. Volcano Discovery. Which volcanoes are erupting right now? VolcanoDiscovery.com. Go to DiscoveryVolcano.com and learn more. Just don't have the time to cover everything today, Steve. And we have a lot more coming up on this solar minimum, our position in space, and some of the activity being observed that ties into some of our earlier stories.
Well, you know, Mr. Earthplay, one of the things we regularly discuss here on earthchangesradio.com is the fact that we are being poisoned by the everyday articles and everyday food products that we have in our system that is being pumped into us. And we do warn about the chemicals that are being used in these foods and indeed in the packaging. And I've always considered that poly chickens are a waste of oxygen, that none of them have our benefit in mind. None of them have our the health benefits or our health of their nation or of their people. None of them have that in their heart. But indeed, things are starting to change. I read a story just this week that Chuck Schumer, the Zionist pro-Israeli stooge, is actually starting to look into the health effects of chemicals in our packaging. Believe it or not, he is starting to ask questions about people being poisoned by bisphenol A, BPA, in the very packaging for fast foods. So this is a step in the right direction for America and indeed for people around the world, that poly chickens are now starting to look at the poisoning of people from the food packaging itself. That's the first time I've ever heard anything like this from any useless oxygen thief politician. But they're starting to look at this, and that can be only a step in the right direction. That's incredible. How is it that they're starting to do this? We talked earlier about the water supply in America and indeed how it's being poisoned, how there is a lot of chemicals and byproducts of the chemicals that we're taking, and indeed the chlorine and the fluoride and everything else they pump in the water. Well, this is indeed a step in the right direction to starting to take the poisons out of our food chain, out of our foods, and indeed out of the packaging that our food is wrapped in. That can only be a good thing. I would think so. Go ahead there, Earthplay.
Oh, I agree with you so much, and I'm going to attribute some of this to Donald Trump. If the audience likes it or they don't like it, because he has really been shaking up the EPA, cutting it, letting people go, more firings, and I'm glad to see it. And he's challenging some of the ineptism and the ludicrous regulations that were coming out of the EPA. I hope this is more is to come. This is just the beginning of this. And it goes wider than that, Steve. It's in all municipalities. It's all of our food, processed, husked, gassed, irradiated, stored. You know, the potatoes that they sell to French fries at McDonald's, they have to be outgassed for 6 weeks in a warehouse. Nobody in there because it's toxic. But these are the French fries they serve at McDonald's. McDonald's, the chemical that they have to outguess for 6 weeks before they can come to market. It's everywhere. We've talked about this before, how Taco Bell and other restaurants, if they have 30% beef in their product, 1% beef. We've had these discussions. It's atrocious. It shouldn't be happening in America. And I also heard a report from checking in with Libby Halibi this weekend, during our hiatus, talking about how Trump may have inadvertently damaged the nuclear industry. He didn't do it on purpose, just through his executive orders that underlie Obama's EPA regulations that take money away from the nuclear industry. They can't call themselves clean green energy anymore. So I think that some positive things are coming out of this if they're ready to recognize that nuclear is clean and green and it is a money pit. I'm glad to see they're looking at this, and the Democratic Party is just having a tizzy over this, saying that no, we need more nuclear, we need more corporations and toxicities and things of that nature, you know. And not only do I complain about these things, I can tell you the solutions to these things. We talk about water filtration all the time. Good friend of mine, James McCanny, at jamesmccanny.com, sells water filters. I talked about the Sawyer water filters. We've demonstrated them on YouTube videos, drinking out of rivers. So, and there's much more, Steve. The vaccine issue. I wish that they would address the vaccine issue. Now it has become a sore thumb here in our community. School teachers, professionals, doctors, the local TV stations, are really jumping on the vaccine wagon here, telling everybody has to be vaccinated, every kid, no exception. They want to make fun and ridicule anybody who refuses to take the vaccine, to marginalize them. That their kid can't go, if everybody is vaccinated, why does your kid need to be vaccinated? What are you worried about? You know, you have one kid that is not vaccinated for whatever reason. Maybe he plays in the mud and he doesn't need those kinds of vaccination. But our society is forcing these things upon us. I'm glad that they're facing the water and the food issues. But it won't be in a timeline that's meaningful to any of us. Because we know that these bureaucrats, they drag their feet for years, not just years and years, decades. Decades. So we have a long way to go here, Steve, that's for damn sure. Look, we even have audience participation tonight.
Well, you know, sir, one fantastic story that I read just recently is that scientists have now found a new continent in between New Zealand and Australia. They're naming it Zealandia. And indeed, the scientists have set sail to try and unlock the secrets of this new continent they've found that is actually under the water, which is fascinating. We've never heard of this before. This is very, very new breaking news about this new continent off the coast of Australia that once actually connected Australia and New Zealand. So they're now finding new places on Earth that have never been seen before that are now being investigated. And the only way they found this was by satellites looking through the oceans and looking through the atmosphere from low Earth orbit, and now they're actually finding these places. So it's fascinating that we're finding out more about Earth's history and about these ancient continents that have never been found before that are now being investigated. They're going to drill down into the continent to find out its geological record, and I find that exciting. I find that incredible. These ancient landmass that we actually have been here all along, that we're only finding out today because of technology. We do have some audience participation, and it's great to see you. Mr. Saban, sir, go ahead. The mic is yours. Please tell us where you're from and your comment, sir. It's great to have you on EarthChangesRadio.com. Your mic.
Thank you. Thank you, Nephilim. Good evening, good morning, wherever you are. Good afternoon. I just want to say hello to all of you. Good to see good people in the room talking about good stuff. What I want to mention, Earth Play, good to see you. Suicide Blonde. I want to say something. You guys talking about how they're trying to poison us with chemicals that they put in everything. They do, Nephilim. You know what happened last year, like what they were trying to do in people in, what they tried to do, what they did in Michigan, in Flint, you know? And as you know, Nephilim, there is so many those toothpaste, you know, that they put fluoride in the freaking toothpaste. And they said if you eat some of the toothpaste, you could die, you know? So why they're like putting the freaking fluoride in the toothpaste for to clean your teeth? You can clean your teeth with, let's say you can use coconut oil and you can use the baking soda, you know? Now I'm saying like if you accidentally eat toothpaste, you can die, you know, if you swallow, yeah. But how come they don't make proper toothpaste so we don't need to worry about this shit? You know, you're smart, Moon. Actually, my wife does it too. You know, vinegar and the lemon and the other stuff. You can make your own cleaner. You can clean up your house. You don't need to buy the junk from freaking what they're trying to sell us. But the other thing, Nephilim, what they're trying to do is they're trying to put vaccine in you. You know, I know. What they did to my daughter when she was like a baby, so she had this allergy reaction. So I refused to put any freaking vaccine in her. And I had a hard time, even I live in Canada, you know. I told them, I'm not gonna give any vaccine to my kid. And then, you know, they told me, you have to do it by law, and they're lying to you, Nephilim. By the Canadian law, nobody can force you to take any vaccine. So I had to do this, all this paperwork. I had to get my lawyer to sign it. So, and even then, they called me. They said, oh, you're putting your kid in risk. I said, my kid is not vaccinated. So if she goes with vaccinated kid, so those kids, they don't need to worry about that because they already had vaccine. You know what I mean, Earthplay? But what they're trying to do, like they're trying to somehow screw you over to tell you, oh, you have to take vaccine, you know? So I did refuse, and this lady on the other side, she was telling me, oh, you have to do it. I said, you know what, lady, you should take that vaccine and stick up your rear end, you know? She said, how dare you? I said, give it to your kid. Instead of my kid, give it to your kid. And I just hang up. I said, don't call me. Don't ever call this freaking telephone number. You know, so we have to be really, really tough with these people, you know, because even they discovered that, you know, the vaccine for the flu, it's a freaking bullshit. The vaccine for the flu, that can cause heart attack, and people can die. Why you don't eat garlic? You eat some like good stuff, natural stuff, so you can prepare yourself and you don't get flu, you know? And the other things, nothing, like, you know what they're trying to do? They're trying to put a chip in you, you know, chip? So they know exactly how much you have, how much you worth, what you do, everything, then they can just unplug you. So you have to refuse this. We have to fight this. And who give them right? Well, ask yourself, who give them, who vote them? I don't vote. Who give them right to impose all this stuff on us? Do we live in democracy or not? Do we live in Afghanistan or do we live in Canada? Anyhow, good room. I do support your room, Earthplay. Mike is yours.
Thank you very much for that, Aban, and you're so right. It's coming. I posted that at Earth Changes Radio on Facebook, how they're starting, some companies are to chip their employee. Daintington, every Saturday morning, we get a vaccine report. They're insidious. These three-stage MMR vaccines that are being forced by legislation on all school children. But, you know, and we were talking about this just before the show, too, Sibon. That the cancer rates in America and the number of people that are dying of cancer and toxins across America and the UK, breakouts almost at pandemic levels all across the world. It's getting insidious. We do need to start talking about these cancers and the toxicity. And even with the solar emissions, the UVs, just like you were talking about, even electrical lines and this new G5 that they're coming out with. What is that right now, Steve? What is it? 4G technology, 5G technology coming out that could that does affect the human sweat glands. Could charge up the body where you're having palpitation, hard time breathing. With our oxygen being depleted on the planet, if you believe that. But we do need to have a show about cancers and toxicity, Steve. I do have a positive solution. If you're being at least cutting down in your own home, filter your water. You're having pharmaceuticals, heavy metals, lead, mercury. We've talked about these things. You're aware of them. Now it's time for you to be proactive and do something about it. Quit using chemicals and pesticides in your home. There are natural pest controls. Come talk to us in the Ancient Observatory on paltalk.com. If you're listening to this audio or watching the video, come talk to us on a Tuesday. I will tell you any natural pest control you need for your home. I live in the Rocky Mountains. We have critters from A to Z. Get rid of ants, gnats, fleas, mosquitoes, flies, roaches, spiders, anything. Natural, simple cures that you can do at home. Easy stuff. And I'll give you an example. Are you having a problem with ants, say, any kind of ant? Little ones, big ones, medium ones, army ants, tree ants, wood ants, it doesn't matter. If you're having a problem with ants or you've seen an ant in your home, get rid of them. And here's a simple, easy way. You don't call the exterminator. You don't get out a can of toxic Raid and breathe that stuff into your lungs. You take 1 tablespoon of baking soda. You take 1 tablespoon of powdered white sugar. You mix it together, and pretty soon you will have no ants, ever. So get rid of fleas, gnats, ticks, flies, mosquitoes by simply boiling cedar wood chips, and you can get it at any pet store because that's what they sell in the lining for mice and rats and other rodents is cedar chips, because they do not and they repel any, almost any insect. So you take those cedar chips, never abuse a live living plant. Always if you can find a cedar tree, take the dry branches, they're just as good. Grind them up, boil them. Make your own cedar side. Get rid of bed bugs. Get rid of ants. Well, that would be poisoning them, but they'll never come back. There are natural ways to get rid of things. You can grow herbs. You can put basil in your drawers to get rid of roaches. Put sprinkle basil in your counters or in your floor bottom counters. You'll never have another roach. So come talk to us at the Ancient Observatory. We're not all about pesticism. We talk about these things, and we'll try to find out a natural remedy together. So let's, you know, we have a lot of problems in the environment right now. Let's not create them in the environments in which we live. Let's minimize, you know, we already have GMOs. We have toxic water. Our air column is polluted with radioactivity, with aluminum, with who knows, whatever they're spraying up there. There are some things that we can mitigate these things in our own lives. Go ahead, Nephilim. Steve.
Well, sir, thank you very much, Mr. Earthplay. Rick, one of the most fascinating stories I found this week, and of course here on Earth Changes Radio, we talk about the changes that are happening under the Earth, the changes that are happening on the Earth, sociologically. And we also talk about the changes that are happening above the Earth, in space, in the cosmos, in our galaxy, and indeed, the very solar system we live in. Just this week, scientists have found that the ingredients for life have been found on Titan. That is Saturn's moon called Titan. They have found the ingredients for life, the very basic building blocks, that the genetic molecules that can make life, they have now found on Saturn's moon Titan. I think this is a fascinating story because, indeed, it shows no matter where you are in our cosmos, that there is a possibility for life just about everywhere, in every different corner of the galaxy, in every different corner of the globe. And indeed, that they found the ingredients for life, the building blocks, the molecules, the chains that actually build multicellular organisms. They have found them already. And I find that incredible. Wherever we look across the universe, across the solar system, there is, in fact, life everywhere. So if you're being told that we here on Earth, we're the only life whatsoever, don't believe it. They're bullshitting to you. Life is everywhere. Life exists because life will always exist. Go ahead there, Saban. Your mic, sir.
Thank you. Can I be heard, please? Can I be heard? I just want to say about the about this, you know, scans. Like, you know, they always want to scan you. You know what I mean? You go to the freaking any place, they put the scan. You go to the dentist, they always, oh, like, you know what, sir, like every 3 months you're supposed to do scan for your cavities. And you know the dentist actually doing these scans, they can actually give you the cancer. You can get cancer, like head cancer, you can get like throat cancer. So don't do it. Like, I refuse. And even, you know, when they clean my teeth, they said that we're supposed to use fluoride. I said, no, I just use the water, just hot water, and just do it. I refuse, like, to take this. And my question is to you, like, how come, like, they're saying we advanced it so much, and they think, how come we have every year people have more and more cancer? I do use moon cyclone. I do use Miswak, but I use the toothpaste without any fluoride. I use the one with baking soda. You can get one in those organic stores. I use that one. I'm asking this question: how come people have more and more cancer, Nephilim, Earthplay, and others? Every year, people have more cancer, and they're saying like they're getting advanced. In what? How come they haven't found the cure for the cancer? Actually, there is a cure for the cancer, but they don't want to give it to you. You know, Nephilim, you know how many of those natural doctors were killed last year in USA? Nephilim, you know those people that they're trying to help help you, you and me? They're killing them, man. They're finding them in the freaking lakes, you know? Yeah, they don't do it suicide blonde. They want you to be a customer. You know the customer? So they tell you for the rest of the life you has to use this drug. And you said, how can I cure my high blood pressure? You can cure it like with vitamins. You can cure with the way that you live, with the food. You can cure your blood pressure. You know, but they're telling you, oh, you're supposed to take these drugs for the rest of your life. And yeah, you know what else, Nephilim? Let's say if you're like over, like if you're 50, you know, they're gonna send you this. I heard from my older cousins, every 6 months they're gonna send you appointments that you have to check your colon, you have to check your all these scans. That the woman, you have to check your breast, and actually this procedures, they're gonna cause people to get cancer. This is how they actually get telling you, come to the hospital, we're gonna give you some cancer, you know. So yeah, so just freaking refuse. Tell them I don't need those freaking tests. Did my grandfather had these tests? They live like for like 70, 80 years old, you know? They never had like breast monogram, whatever they call it, you know? They barely had breast cancers. They barely had colon cancer. But you know why people getting colon cancer? Because of the food. They don't walk too much. They're not active. Most of them, they sit on their fat ass. They don't do anything, you know? And especially food. Especially food, they eat too much, you know, they're Humpty Dumpty, you know, sitting on wall, you know. Anyhow, Brother Earthplay, mic is yours.
Thank you, Saban, and I'm going to give you an honest answer. You're not going to like it, but I'm going to give you the answer. Why is so much cancer and toxicity? Before the 1950s, cancer was the rarest thing that a person could get. But now, in our generation, cancer is an epidemic. Dementia, Alzheimer's, buildup of aluminum in the fatty tissue of the brain, causing Pyron diseases. And I'm going to tell you this honestly. I believe most of this is coming from the nuclear industry. Chernobyl and Fukushima, which has been an ongoing airborne nuclear fission going on 7 years now. And I truly believe that most, 50% of the population along the west coast of the United States within the next couple of years will have cancer and die of cancer. That the cancer rates, the epidemics, and the instances of encephalitis in newborns has been untrackable. It's just off the scale. There is no scale for the amount of death and misery from the nuclear industry and the people that are dying of all of these cancers. Now, it takes 5 to 8 to 10, maybe 20 years before a radioactive particle lodged in the tissue of your body becomes active and starts to screw your immune system and your body organs. I can I'm telling you, I firmly believe this is because of the nuclear industry, the ongoing toxicity of Fukushima, and the first barrier from radiation is in the plants and animals, which we're eating. It's bioaccumulative. It just builds more and more and more in the tissue of animals and plants, and we consume it. And people who consume a lot of these particles are going to get it much more rapidly. So we are consuming it in our food chain. And I've said this before. People don't believe me. There's no reason that you should believe me. But every time that it rains and snows, at least 50% of those particles are radioactive. Your rain and your snow is radioactive. Used to be that you could go out into a nice thunderstorm, sit on the porch, and it would give you a good, easy healing. It would kind of put you at rest and cleanse you, but not anymore. If you're out in the rain or a thunderstorm, you're probably going to get nausea, sick. You're not going to feel well. The next day, you're going to be violently ill. It is raining down right now. Not only the radiation from Chernobyl, which is still circling the Earth, and the radiation from Fukushima that is like a toxic fountain that you just can't shut it off. And every time that it rains, at least, or even more, of the volume of the rain and snow is radioactive. Now, you have no reason to believe me because you haven't seen it on television and your politicians haven't told you this. But it is true. If you do the work yourself and you look into the research of cancers and nuclear industry and encephalitis, clusters of outbreaks of deaths, cancer deaths, and we know these things are going on nationwide. We know for a fact. Going, look at the mortality rate of Hanford County in Hanford, Washington. Look at the Tennessee Valley Authority. They have 7 nuclear power plants there. Look at the clusters of encephalitis and cancer outbreaks. These things are not coincidences. And it's very unfortunate that people even have to report these things, that the nuclear fallout from Fukushima is now over the entire volume of North America. Every person in North America has inhaled at least one or more radiological nucleotides, and you always had a chance of inhaling these from the atomic testing from the Southern Pacific atolls. So, you know, I did answer your question. It was kind of lengthy and a lot of opinion in there as well, but it was an honest answer. I know you didn't like the answer, but and I have one more thing. Now, since we are running into overtime, I did want to bring a more news story. Earlier in the show, I told you about the composition of the Earth's environment being 78% nitrogen, 21% oxygen, and 0.2% other rare gases and carbon dioxide. Well, here is something that is going to, now, if you're mentally ill or prone to depression or anything, turn the radio off now. Just end the video, turn the volume off, because you do not want to hear this. The oxygen level on the Earth has been depleted for just the last 10 years, from 21% oxygen to 20.1%. Now, here is the most extraordinary thing, and if a scientist didn't tell you this to your face, and they told me to my face, you probably wouldn't understand it or believe it. But beyond the orbit of Jupiter and Saturn, okay, within the space of Jupiter and Saturn, all the way to the Sun, the rarest element is, think about it, what do you think it is? It's nitrogen. Now, our atmosphere is 78% nitrogen by volume, but there is no nitrogen in the inner solar system at all. Even on the moons of Jupiter and Saturn. Once you get beyond Jupiter and Saturn, guess what becomes the most abundant besides hydrogen? is nitrogen. So nitrogen, the further you get away from our solar system, the thicker it gets. And this is the subs of our life, nitrogen and oxygen. But I found it was extraordinary that nitrogen does not exist in the inner solar system. Only in the outer solar system and well beyond. But yet, our Earth is 78% nitrogen. And we're having a problem with that as well, and we'll have to leave that for another show. But all of these chemical changes that are happening in the environment, and actually, I even heard recently, and I've talked about it before, so it's not a recent story, how the resonant frequency of hydrogen, and you can look it up online, the resonant frequency of hydrogen, the most abundant element in all of known creation, space, everywhere we look, it's everywhere. This hydrogen signature, the frequency that it oscillates, everything has a frequency, a vibration in space, is 11.5. Okay, look it up. It's 11.5, the resonant frequency of hydrogen. Well, they recently discovered that this frequency oscillation of the Schumann resonance is increasing. The Schumann resonance now of hydrogen is 11.77, and it's unexplainable. Does that mean that the other vibrations of space, say of nitrogen, of oxygen, will also change? And is this also affecting our sun, putting it into a deep, deep, deep solar minimum? For all of you who are looking for Planet X, it's not here yet. Nothing has crossed the heliosphere boundary that is the size of the Earth's moon or larger. We can definitively say that without being proven wrong or ridiculed. So if you're looking for Planet X, Nibiru, Nemesis, Wormwood, it is not here. Okay? Now, we don't see it coming. But we do see a lot of waves coming at us, like tsunami waves in the ocean, coming at us from the Milky Way galaxy along the dark rift. We call them photon belts, or as I like to call them, the Ibex waves. And we're in for a doozy, Timber. In the next 30 days, we're going to be starting to be hit by a lot more of these highly charged particles, and you can see them now, today, for yourself, do your own research at the Lawrence Livermore National Laboratories, which is making a composite map using all of our satellite technology combined to overlay one program over the other program over the other to build a composite map of the galactic plane. And much like you, they don't like what they're discovering. So, Steve, that's what I have for this week. Hey, thanks everyone for being a part of Earth Changes Radio. To everybody in the chat room, glad to have you there. I appreciate all of you. See us next Tuesday. We'll be here for the rest of the night as well. But thank you. Over to you, Steve.
Well, God bless you, Earthplay, for your diligence and indeed your research skills, because we need people like this. We need people like you on the ball as we go through this next series or this next episode of Earth Changes that we're seeing, and indeed we will be seeing very, very soon. I do have one last thing to say, and indeed why the oxygen is being depleted from our atmosphere. I think there are too many oxygen thieves. Too many people who are breathing the air that is for us human beings, and indeed they're not giving anything back to the earth. And these oxygen thieves, well, you can name them as politicians. You can name them as the corporations. You can name them as the CEOs of the big companies that rule this planet with an iron fist and love to bring war to civilians and to citizens and to people who do not deserve it, the innocents that die in their wars just so they can get a share price profit. That's the kind of world we're living in. And unfortunately, these oxygen thieves, they haven't been locked up yet. But we are seeing the changes in the world today. With the arrest of Imran Awan last week, that is the first domino that will bring down the dominoes, and I would wake up one day and see Hillary Clinton in handcuffs, see Bill Clinton in handcuffs, to see George W. Bush in handcuffs. That is the one thing I would love to see, only because these people have caused so many murders and so many deaths around the world. This would be a real earth-changing moment for me, and I would love to wake up one day and read that headline. You've been listening to Earth Changes Radio, episode 21, which is the first of season 2, episode 1, season 2, which is called Ancient Observatory Report. Hope you enjoyed the show just as much as I did. Thanks very much. Please do stick around. We're going to have some discussion after the show, but it's been great to have you all here. It's been great to have the admins and, of course, all the regulars right here on the show. Don't forget our sponsors, which include which includes Organites by Mishkaites, which includes howtowinincourt.com, and, of course, the Southwest Backpacker, who sponsor this show right here. God bless you all. Hopefully you're taking care, and hopefully this world is starting to be a better place. You've been listening to Rick and Steve on the Terraforming Earth Network. God bless you all. Take care. Bye for now.